This is Captain Jackson of the 17th Infantry. We are pinned, I repeat, we are pinned by over 28 U.S. gunfire surrounding us. Backup is needed.
I could hear Captain Jackson's desperate call for help. There was a short pause before a response came in, but even before the response came, we knew reinforcements were going to come in time, and my fellow Marines knew it as well. The communication device crackled on.
Jackson, ETA for reinforcements is 20
minutes. Negative. We're pinned. We need quicker reinforcement.
The captain responded with exasperation. Then the other side came.
Negative, Captain. The only alternative is short-range ballistic missiles.
Captain, we can't do that, I objected. The impact would be well over 500 kilometers. It risks civilian casualty. The captain nodded. We would have to fight our way out.
Negative, please. Cancel SOBM. Get me any reinforcements in the area and air support.
All troops are occupied. Air support will arrive momentarily.
The base responded.
Alright, there's gonna be a momentary distraction from air support, so there's no time to lose. Get smoke grenades, clear the area.
He commanded, quickly cocking his M16 rifle. I glanced at Lewis, who was to my right. He nodded as he grabbed his smoke grenade.
Base to Jackson, the recon plane is overhead. General Perkins orders you to return home ASAP.
Copy.
He responded as he looked at me and the others.
Alright, when I give the order.
We prepared to throw grenades, tensely awaiting his command.
Light them up.
Captain Jackson yelled as we activated our grenades. The plane roared over us, enveloping us with thick gray fumes. For precious seconds as we lunged for our lives, adrenaline fueled us as the enemy quickly discovered our plane and showered us with gunfire. A split second later, we emerged from the smoke. The enemy pursued us from the rooftops, ensuring we didn't escape easily. Gripping my rifle tightly, I could hear our captain shouting into his comms.
Captain Tippers, we're en route. Need pickup now.
Copy. Reinforcement has been launched.
The second we exposed ourselves from protection in the alley.
Grab cover!
Jackson yelled as we got behind some objects.
Ugh, shots from 12 and 1 o'clock!
Lewis shouted as we got behind the same metal barrel. I watched from behind as he returned fire. The situation only intensified as I frantically looked around, trying to find any hope of escaping. Glancing back towards Lewis, I noticed some writing on the barrel and immediately recognized it. Jihad, war against Islam's enemies. In other words, we had walked right into the baited trap. Images from training flashed into my mind, but it was too late. It had happened so fast I didn't have time to take in the surroundings. Lewis, we gotta get out of here, I shouted, anticipating an explosion at any moment.
Great idea, why didn't I think of that?
He said sarcastically, getting behind cover as he reloaded. I grabbed his arm before he got up. Look! I pointed at the words inscribed on the barrel. He looked at me with fears in his eyes. He knew exactly what I was thinking. I yelled at the captain from the other side. Sir, get out, now! We got bombs, this is a trap!
Copy, I'll cover you!
The captain grunted, cursing aloud. I went to push Lewis out first, but he resisted. Then I noticed a fresh blood stain on my glove. Looking up, I saw that Lewis' left shoulder was drenched in the same blood. It took me a moment to realize that he'd been shot in the neck. Cap, Lewis is hit!